eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest to me to do. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thy own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. Only the number of those that God will glorify among you. When Jesus was sent into this world, he brought the destiny of glory into this world. Glory is important in the life of anybody. Jesus that brought us all together knows the importance of glory. He knows how the glory is being appreciated. For once to be married for 3 years, 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, 21 years, no child to send on an errand. What is your fairy? The question people will ask you when you send their children, where is your own child? The glory of being married after marriage is your child. All those canker worms in your life that are not good, you cannot use it to appreciate your life.
Money can marry.
I can count 5, 6, 10 in the life of each of you. It is the clothes you are wearing that are cover them. You know, when you are going, people usually say they are fond of it. He is going again. Where is the glory of all his effort? It is important for you to have glory.
If you
do not understand this message, I plead the Holy Spirit to explain it to you so that you will know how to take a step for you to have a glory. And what we are going to do about your life as solution is so simple. This is what we are going to do. Just concentrate and believe. And believe yesterday is history, today is different. When a problem is pursuing one and persists and do not go away, and he pursues you into Christ's auditorium, it is a must for that problem to run back. I want to give you a simple illustration for you to understand. A woman, she was married for 16 years. She never had one child.
16 years.
And her first pregnancy, after 16 years, that pregnancy was delayed inside her womb for her not to deliver the baby. Look straight to the man of God. When she was to conceive, and people said, so you can conceive. Okay, we're not going to allow you to burn the baby. If you go burn them at all, we will turn that baby to stone. The enemy of the world can change one's glory into blemish and humiliation. Who is that individual that God did not create with glory? Every part of the system of your body is full of the glory of God. But when you go to this world, and the wicked people turn your destiny into a bad one, they will now remove that glory and turn it to shame and blemish. That was what happened in the life of the woman I'm talking about. And she was in that pregnancy for 5 good years. People were expecting her to deliver after 16 years. But the last place she was before she came to a crusade, as the way you came now, ask the question. Ask, where did she go last? It was a Babalawo. On getting to that herbalist, the herbalist said, hey, welcome, madam. Where you there since all these days? You don't know, say, Nami, they do for everybody like you. The woman said, Baba, no, no, now somebody explained that now you be the person where feel do
harm.
If you want to go and ease yourself, this is the time for you not to do that. Sit down. What you're going to do is simple. This is your pregnancy. You go burn am. You go burn am. But this is the system you go take. In the early morning, 7 continuous days, you will wake up by 4:30 a.m. in the morning, before the day is done. You now go to the dustbin. You start to suspect the first person to defecate on the
dust.
The Babalawo told the woman that for 7 days continuously, you will go to the dustbin by 4:30 in the morning. Start to suspect the first person, either man or woman, child or baby, that will come to that dustbin and defecate. Even if not the defecation of dysentery or that one with disease, the first one, just collect instant bovita thing. Bring them for me. If big problem fall upon somebody, little KKK problem, we start to maneuver over the
person.
Look at the position and places the enemy has led you to today. You are to be greater than what you are now. Your relative and family are the ones that are making you to be a continuous backbencher. You are a front bencher. How you, your front you yourself cannot explain it. The juncture in which you are now you are confused. That is why you are on this auditorium tonight. I say it in the name of Jesus. At the point you are in tonight, You have got to the point of your solution.
Say a
great and loud amen. Amen. And this woman did exactly what the Babalawo told her. I'm getting to the Babalawo. And he collected it from her. In the evening, come and collect what you have brought to me. And I put it in that feces of somebody else, maybe with disease. He now collect it on a flat pot. What did he do? He fried that. And in the evening, when she got there,